LinkedIn is the hottest social platform right now. Why? People are on there with intent. They have the intent to do business. It's not the same as Instagram, not the same as Facebook, and definitely not the same as TikTok. So what we're going to do in this video is walk through one of LinkedIn's paid tools called Sales Navigator. I'm going to do a whole free training on it so you guys get to understand how you can identify potential clients and then how you can use the LinkedIn Sales Nav functionality to turn them into leads. So we're on the main screen of LinkedIn Sales Navigator. And across the top, we have these four tabs. What we're going to do is actually ignore those tabs and go into lead filters and account filters. Now, there's a difference between both, and people sometimes get a bit confused with this. Leads are personal profiles, so they're people and they're personal LinkedIn profiles, and we're going to filter down to find the ideal clients there. Alternatively, accounts are business pages or business profiles on LinkedIn. So depending on who you sell to or who you want to find, you can use one of these or both. But what we're going to do first is go into lead filters. And you'll see here, as soon as we click through, you're hit with so many filters. A little bit overwhelming for some people, I imagine, but they're broken down into different sections, okay? Company, role, spotlights, content, personal, and workflow. So what we're able to do is take everyone who's on LinkedIn and narrow them down to our ideal client profile using certain search criteria, okay? So we're going from a massive number all the way down to a select few. And to give you an idea of this, I'm gonna come to the personal section and I'm gonna just see how many people there are in the United Kingdom on LinkedIn, okay? 33 million, far too many to try and sell to, okay? So we're gonna use this criteria to try and drill down into our ICP. And for this video, I'm gonna make up an ideal client profile. That ideal client profile is going to be marketing contacts at IT companies. So we're going to go through each section and see how that might be relevant and how we can apply these filters with the aim of getting that 33 million down quite significantly. So first of all, we want to look at the company headcount. Who are we selling to? Well, we might say it's anywhere between 11 employees and 200. And straight away, we're going to see this number go down here. It's gone from 33 mil to 4. So we've cut quite a few people out, which is perfect. Now, we may have target companies that we want to sell to. So if we wanted to, we could put them in here. Let's just, for now, use Apple. Obviously, we can take that out. And that drills down to only 281 people. Perfect. But we're actually not searching for Apple. So if we wanted to play around with this, we can just exclude Apple from the search. And there are still, as we say, 4 million people there, okay? If we wanted to look at people that had worked at, let's say, I don't know, Nike, for example, and I know these companies don't necessarily have this many employees, but it's just an example. So people who now work at companies between 11 and 200 employees and used to work at Nike, there are 1,000 of them. Brilliant. I'm not sure why we'd need that, but just showing you. Again, company type, we can look at private companies. Is it publicly held? Are we looking for nonprofits? You can drill down there. And then where are they based? Where's the HQ or the headquarters based? Because there may be people in the United Kingdom that you want to sell to who have head offices in North America, let's say, okay? But we'll leave that blank for now. Then a really exciting one, because we're trying to sell into marketing departments, we can drill down and filter by their current job title. And this is where I think LinkedIn Sales Nav sort of plays its most effective part. So let's just put marketing in there. What I'm going to do is just hit enter. You don't have to actually select a job title, although if you wanted to, you could go marketing director, let's say. Cool. So we've got marketing there, and that's gone down to 110. Brilliant. If you can't find people there, or if you want to look for other aspects, you can look at what function they're in. So it may be that we look at marketing in here instead. However, I think going off current job title, because people are quite keen to show off job titles on LinkedIn, is a great shout. We might also want to look at how senior they are. So, okay, let's just look at marketing directors rather than anyone below that. Still 24. Cool. And then have they been there for a while? You know, we might not want to sell to new people. We might want to sell to established people who've been in the company for a while. Alternatively, we might only want to sell to newer people. So we will click less than a year. Let's just stick that in there. Got that down to 3K. Perfect. Now, another great part of this search functionality is the spotlight section. So we can actually look at people that have changed jobs in the last 90 days, or if we want to only target people that we know are active on LinkedIn and have posted in the last 30 days, then we can bring that number down again and make sure that these people are active. Brilliant. Now, one thing underneath that I don't think is particularly relevant is the keyword section. So if these people aren't posting articles, which a lot of people on LinkedIn aren't, this section's kind of redundant. So I'm going to ignore that and I suggest that you do the same. So now we're looking at anyone who works at companies between 11 and 200 people who are marketing in a senior level role, been there less than a year. And we've already got this down quite a bit, but we might want to get it down further. So let's say we only want to speak to or identify people that we're not connected with, who aren't connections of ours on LinkedIn. So we go with second and potentially third degree connections there. Obviously, you can just go with people who you are connected with. Might be a warmer route, but in this search, we're going slightly wider. Cool. And then now we can go into location even further. Let's say this was still at 1 million. We may want to sort of identify some of the key cities in the United Kingdom. Let's just get rid of that for a second. So Manchester, quite close to me. How many senior marketing directors who've been at their company of 11 to 200 people for less than a year are based in Manchester? 61. So this is really interesting now, because that's a number that we can actually work with. However, I'm going to widen it out and go back to United Kingdom. And if for some reason I didn't want to sell into Manchester or people that were based in Manchester, I can just click this little sign here and it will exclude anyone from Manchester from this search. Cool. Then we might want to go into industry, and we're probably going to look at tech, information and internet. So we're really drilling down now. Perfect. We have now found probably the best people that we can sell into. Another thing we can look at is if we wanted to target connections of specific people. So my head of client success is called Vicky. So I'm going to stick her name in there and see how many of these are connected to her. I'm not surprised, not any. But if you have someone who is sort of highly recognized in your space with a big following on LinkedIn, you might want to be able to use them as a leverage point to start a conversation with some of these people. So you can put that person's name in here. I'm guessing you have to be connected with them. Also, if there are any mutual groups that you might want to target people from, you can stick them in. You may want to know someone's or already know someone's first name or last name, so you can put that in there. And then if for some reason, you know, you wanted to target their profile language as only English, which I imagine the majority of these are, or their school for some reason, you can put that in there too. Lead lists and people in your CRM are on a different package to the one that I'm on. That's slightly higher. I think that's the top level package. And this persona is quite new too. So we're going to ignore these for now. I think we've got a nice bulletproof 149 people that we can go after and start conversations with. So we're going to save that search and we'll just call it UK IT marketing directors. And what we're going to be able to do is bring this search up in the future when we want to work through them. Okay, so we have our list built. We have our list saved. Now what do we do in order to get in contact with these people? Well, you've got two options. You can either connect with them straight away, because we're not actually connected with any of these people as yet, or you can send them a message straight away. It's up to you how you deal with these things. I think it's always better to try and connect with people first. So I would just click connect. If I wanted to check out Mike's profile, for example, I could click view profile, and it actually would take me, not on LinkedIn, so he won't be aware of this, it will take me directly to his profile through Sales Navigator. So it won't notify Mike that I've viewed his profile. Here, I can also find similar leads. So we have a growth marketing manager, perhaps someone who sits underneath Mike. We can also go and look at his about section, potentially look at his recent activity and use that as a starting point for a conversation. We could ask someone who we are both connected with to introduce us. So we're both connected with a lady called Laura, and we can view some more connections there. And then we can go and look at his experience too, which is pretty cool. So if we had any insight or had worked with Car Gurus, for example, or Quantcast, we could use that as a selling point as well. But coming back to our lead list, coming back to our saved search, we can now see that we've viewed Mike's profile. We may want to message him, okay? And I'm not a big advocate for cold messages straight out the gate. It might be your style, and you actually have the ability to do that here by clicking on this message icon. That will bring up what's called an in-mail. So it's not like sending someone a normal DM on LinkedIn. These are limited. You get 150 credits every single month to use at your disposal. You also have to include a subject. So you want to be very careful about what you write here. You want to grab the person's attention, and don't sell straight out the gate is my advice when sending DMs. The first DM that you send should have one objective and one objective only, and that is to get a reply. Don't try and get Mike to click on your lead magnet. Don't try and invite him to a call straight away or pitch him. Just mention something that you have in common, some form of common ground, whether it's a page that you follow, a group that you're in. It could potentially be the connection that we saw, the mutual connection. I think her name was Laura, and stick that in there. And that is how you can start to identify and drill down into a potential lead list and then turn those people into leads by having conversations as well. Next, if we wanted to look at accounts, it actually carries the information over for us, which is brilliant. But what you probably want to do here is start afresh. So let's just look at the company attributes first and foremost. So we might want to look at the turnover, which is going to be really good for people who may have marketing spend. Let's look at, let's say we want to go from 5 to 10 mil. Okay, let's add that in there. How many businesses are doing that? Brilliant. Cool. So again, what we can do is start to drill these down even further by location, company headcount, growth as well is an interesting one. And jobs, you know, if you work in recruitment or help businesses scale, you might be very interested in which businesses are actually hiring and advertising those positions on LinkedIn. Again, we can go down even further into how many page followers they have. Are they a Fortune company? What kind of tech do they use? Really, really crucial stuff that we can start to look at. I imagine this might be quite limited, but if we wanted to look at who's using Google Ads right now, let's say you're an agency, then you can actually tap into these businesses. I think what we want to do now, now we're happy with all this, so they've got some recent activities or they've had funding, we can then save this search and we'll call it account search one. That'll do. And then we actually get, same with the other one, we actually get weekly emails about new results that will appear in our save searches panel. Fantastic. So hacker job, never heard of them. Sounds interesting. They're hiring at the moment. They've got 186 employees, 8.7 to 16.5 mil in annual revenue. Do we want to view the company? And then we can look at similar companies as well, similar to the last page. And then we can also save them. So we can add them to new lists or whatever it may be. Cool. So let's take a look at hacker job. We want to go and view their profile. Let's say I'll open that in a new tab. Cool. Now, the information that we get access to here is brilliant because we can identify the number of employees, which is within our target range, but we can also look at who the decision makers are at that business, okay? So let us take a look. We've got the CEO, we've got the VP of the marketplace, we've got chairman, head of revenue operations, and again, we're now back in this leads list, so we can start to filter these people down. You know, we may just want the marketing connections, for example, so we can look at current job title again and put in marketing. Let's see how many of them there are. Brilliant. Daisy Kent. We have one person that we need to speak to. And we can do the same as we just went through, either send her a message or connect with her. The beauty of this is now we can also start to add in some of those similar companies too. So let's look at talent.io. Again, head of brand marketing. It's taking the businesses that we're interested in speaking to and filtering them down based on our search criteria. So two ways of handling LinkedIn Sales Nav. And then you have the option as to whether you connect with these people or whether you DM them, but you know, or you're 80% sure that these people are in your target market. I hope that's helpful. I'm going to do another video where we talk specifically about sending connection requests and sending DMs. My one piece of advice is not to pitch or spam people. I don't even send any personalized message when I connect with people. I think it comes across a little bit desperate, but I will leave that part up to you. But if you are interested in finding out more or how you can dominate LinkedIn using organic content, I've got a couple of freebies available beneath this video. One is a content planner and one is a free 13-minute training where I show you the 5 secrets to 5-figure months on LinkedIn. Alternatively, if you just want to stay on YouTube and keep browsing, I've put together this video here, which shows you the 15 secrets about LinkedIn that you need to know and start implementing straight away. That's it for this video. I'll see you in this video next.